How you doing, buddy? Another week underway here. You know, we're now in the middle of August. Sun's hot. It wasn't like that this entire week, though. For those of you who are outside, you know exactly what I'm talking about. We had a lot of rain this week, so much that you had standing water, flash flood warnings, some cold weather, very non-typical for the month of August. And it did put the fish in a funk. Those fish moved tight into the weeds, or they stayed hunkered down on deep weed lines. A lot of anglers were catching their bass, their panfish, in 25, 28 feet of water. We caught some fish in the thick weeds, but we had to work for them. So one technique I want to show you to start things off that seemed to work very well is, we talked last week about the wacky rig, how we've been catching a lot of fish on the wacky rig. And we've kind of changed approaches recently to drop shotting that wacky rig. So all we've done, a little different than what we used last time, was drop shot weight only about 10, 12 inches down, wacky rig on a worm hook. That seems to be working very well for those bass because they still want that really slow action. But if they're in there down deep, you know what? Sometimes just pitching an unweighted wacky rig all the way down to the bottom of the lake and let's say 18, 20 feet of water can be very painful. So using a drop shot approach for a wacky rig is a great way to catch fish. It's an easy way for anglers of all ages and skill levels to catch fish. Oh, there's a sunfish behind us right there on the dock. Jack's catching bluegills off the dock. Even Jack will fish this drop shot wacky rig to get fish to go. So try that technique if you haven't already. Drop shots, I know, are getting kind of beaten with the dead horse, but that wacky rig setup has worked really well for bass on those deep weed lines. Otherwise, we've been out there. Recently, we've been catching fish on those outside weed lines, keeping the boat out and casting in. You don't want to be inside the thick stuff. You see a lot of anglers get way up tight to the weeds and they're just pulling balls of weeds back to the boat. That's not what you want to do right now. You want to work yourself off that weed line. You want to position the boat, depending on the lake, 18, 20 feet of water casting up. There's even fish in 18, 20, 22 feet of water. If you're on lakes like Minnetonka, Waconia, Forest Lake, I can go down a slew of them. There's that deep coontail. That starts at that 18 foot range and goes out as deep as we find it in 26, 28 feet of water. So look at your Vexilar, look at your locators, look at your electronics, and look for those weeds out there in deeper water. That's where your big bass, your big panfish, you're gonna get your pike, your occasional walleye, that's where they're sitting, is on that deep weed areas. If you can find rock within those deep weeds, that's even better. That gravitates more bait fish, which then pushes in bass, pushes in walleye to sit on those spots. So this is the time of year you want to pay close attention to your electronics. You want to find the weeds off those deep edges. You want to find the hard bottom. The best way to find hard bottom is to use that Vexilar flasher in your boat. I run it off my bow and I set it two or three times the depth of what I'm fishing. So you can see that second echo. That second echo is basically twice the distance of the depth on your Vexilar screen. You're going to see it kind of appear. That's where you know your bottom content changes. That's how you find your hard bottom. It always works. Works exceptionally well. You can do it very similarly on your Lowrance or Hummingbird system by adjusting the depth area so you can see that second echo. It'll show you that as well. So pay attention to those sorts of things. Otherwise, some of the baits we're fishing, other than the wacky drop shot, the jig worm continues to catch a ton of fish. We're using light jig heads and probably 5-inch pocket phenom worms. You're going to pitch it on the weed line and let it go all the way down. So when I make a cast, instead of clicking the bail right when it hits the water, it hits the water and I pull my line up before flicking the bail. So that gives you another 10, 12 feet, then click your bail. And what that does is that bait just drops straight down that weed line. Instead of hooking the bail and it pendulum swings back to the boat, you're not catching those fish that are right in the bottom of that weed line. So pitch to where you want to cast, pull your line out, now flick the bail and let it drop all the way down before you even start to engage the retrieve. A lot of times you get bit right away in the bottom of that hook set. Easy way to fish that. And you can do the same thing with your small jigs if you're fishing bluegills and crappies. If you're using small tubes and small plastics, same approach. A lot of anglers are trying to fish the bobber approach this time of year and you're catching smaller fish because there are not as many big ones up in the shallows. If you're gonna bobber fish, switch to a slip bobber. Fish the weed line with a slip bobber. Drop it down, reel up a couple feet off the bottom, pin your knot there, and that's about where you wanna fish. So if you wanna still continue to use a bobber, that's perfectly fine for your bluegills, your crappies, your walleyes. But turn to a slip bobber approach because you're probably going to be fishing in deeper water. Otherwise, we got some warm weather ahead of us. It's going to hit 80 this weekend. We're going to be getting some nice warm temps. There's not a cloud in the sky behind us. Jack's going to keep trying to catch bluegills off the dock. Get the family out. It's a great time to catch some fish. Get out there and chase them. You know, for the pike, you're still getting them on weed lines, trolling crankbaits. control that 1.5, 2.5 miles per hour, get a DT10, something that dives deep, dives 10 feet, 12 feet, get right in that weed line. They're tighter to the weed line, you're just covering ground. See if you can catch some of them pike. The walleyes are biting the drop shot. I'm just downsizing what I'm using. I'm using a small little minnow type bait, like a 3-inch sashi shad, or maybe a VIE shiner. You can throw on some type of gulp. You can throw on a leech, a live bait. Those are catching your walleyes. And the musky fishermen are getting out there, getting after it. I see a lot of them fishing right when I get on the water in the morning. They're ending their day. So the low light periods this time of year when the waters start hitting, we're looking at 76, 78 degree water temp for the surface. And it's right away in the morning. It's gonna probably hit 80 today. So the musky anglers are going out there after dark and staying there until the sun comes up. Great time to catch muskies. Otherwise, get out there, have some fun. Great time to fish the riverbanks too for the smallie fishermen, those that want to chase smallmouth bass. Fish the riverbanks, get some medium-sized sucker minnows and put them on just an octopus hook and a weight about 18 inches up, maybe an 1/8 ounce to a 1/2 ounce weight, so you can stay in the bottom. That's gonna catch your smallmouth bass. So a lot happening right now. I know I threw a lot at you. The key is to get out there, enjoy the weather. We're in the middle of August. You're gonna have a lot of sun. Put the sunscreen on, get a nice hat, get a nice pair of sunglasses, and wear the protective clothing if you want to do that. So otherwise, have fun, get out there, and we'll see you next week. Hopefully you catch some more fish. Right, Jack?